Start recording. Yes, thank you. It says hit. Thank you. Thank you very much for reminding me to hit record. Today I'm drawing the Ankheg in my 20-minute monster series, where I go through every letter of the alphabet in the monster manual and draw one of the monsters. Let me just confirm that it is. Yes, it's recording. 23 seconds in. Perfect. And today we're listening to Akira Ifukube, who is a Japanese composer who did the classic Godzilla kaiju monster movies back in the 50s and 60s. And that's fun. The Ankheg. Let's find out about the Ankheg. The Ankheg burrows through the earth like an earthworm, preferring soil rich in minerals and organic matter. Thus, it will usually be found in forests and choice agricultural land. This causes farmers great consternation, since the Ankheg likes to supplement its earthly diet of soil with a bit of fresh meat, human or otherwise. Since its mouth is not designed to rip and tear meat, its mandibles crush its prey and secrete a digestive enzyme, causing an additional 1 to 4 points per turn until the prey is completely dissolved. If sorely pressed in battle, it is able to squirt its digestive acids 30 feet once per 6 hours. However, when it does this, it cannot digest anything for the same length of time, so it will usually bite. A squirt of digestive acid causes 8 to 32 hit points of damage to the creature struck, half if the creature makes its saving throw. The Ankheg's favorite method of attacking is lying 5 to 10 feet underground, underneath the ground, until its antenna detects a likely victim passing overhead. Then it burrows out directly underneath the prey and grabs it. Description: the Ankheg has a chitinous shell, which is brownish in color. Its underside is pinkish. I'm not doing color. I'm just doing black and white. Or my color of choice is brown right now, as you can see. The creature's eyes are glistening black. Perfect. This artwork is by Dave Trampier? One of the original Monster Manual artists. And it's great stuff. I'm going to show you a couple others. Apparently, the Ankheg was created by Errol Otis, one of the other famous D&D artists, who did a lot of the covers for. He did the covers for Deities and Demigods. He did a bunch of the module covers, and he has this kind of I don't know, how do you describe it? Cartoonish psychedelic, not too psychedelic, but. It's you can definitely tell an Errol Otis when you see one. And so then it was put into the Monster Manual. This is another Dave Trampier. Oops, that's the wrong layer. This is from the Dungeon Master's Guide, but someone has colorized it. I do like one of the things I do like. I haven't started drawing yet, so the timer is not going. Is this part here, if you can see what I'm drawing, but that little, I don't know how you describe it, it has like a, on his chest, and I think you can see it in the other picture too. Yeah, this kind of like it reminds me of a deer hoof print. This, I'm gonna see if I can incorporate that into my version in between the segments. Oh shit, I'm drawing now. It actually looks kind of like a little yonic as well, doesn't it? But that's not part of the official drawing, so it doesn't count. Undo. And then lastly, so we've seen that one. This is second edition by one of my art heroes, Tony Ditterlezzi, who is also a writer. He's written a bunch of books. The Lampwick Chronicles? Is that right? Is that the name of the book series he did? So I quite like this too. In later editions of the Monster Manual, 3rd edition, 4th edition, and 5th edition, I feel like the Ankheg is a lot more meaty, a lot more bulky. I like how Tony really went with long antenna compared to the original. So that's cool. I don't have them, but I do like the illustrations for the Ankheg in the later editions, but I'm going to try to stick a bit closer to the original design for this Ankheg. So it is now 10:09. We're going to aim for 10:30. We're going to see how far I get. I'm trying to decide if I should do a rough underlay or if I should just commit to one layer and see how I do. Is my brush size too big? No, I feel like that's okay. Okay, so as we know, they lurk underneath the soil with their antennas sticking out of the earth. And then they grab. It's kind of like the Tremors, the graboids from Tremors, but more insect. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to include a victim as well. I have a vision in my mind. Let's see how it works out in paper. I'm gonna delete everything, except I need my color just in case I decide to switch it around. Okay, let's go. He's got his head there. We're gonna have him rearing up through the soil, kind of like a snake. I might have to bring back my I didn't leave room for the antenna, so I'm already not happy, but that's fine. Wouldn't it be cool if, okay, so he's got his antenna. Whee! And what if he's got like a big chunk of earth on his head because he just reared up? And then, oh, here's an important consideration: size. Let's pause for a second. 10 to 20 feet long. Okay, so if I'm just going to draw this right on this layer, so if a human is about 5 feet tall, then the our good friend the Ankheg would be at least twice that. So not huge, unless you go the full 20, then it is quite huge, actually. Okay, so that's helpful. So we're going to put this little... Here's our... Oh, no, don't kill me! Is he a farmer, or is he like an adventurer? His hat, of course. I think it looks like he's a farmer, doesn't it? I want to give him a little more twist, but don't spend too much time on the victim, Torn. This is a monster drawing. Yeah. We don't need to see his face, so that's fine. Okay, so let's start with the eyes. Let me get my reference here. Again, I don't want to copy it. I want this to be like my own style, but it'll help to have the reference so I don't miss anything important. Eyes. Nope, wrong spot, because this is going to be the chunk of soil. I'm going to draw along you with, got my sketchbook, Evil Critters. Wonderful. Perfect. So this is the soil. The goal. This series might end up being the 30-minute monsters. If this isn't working out, but let's make those just quite black all the way, and his mandibles. I was looking up mouth parts, insect mouth parts. They're very complicated. So let's make them appear a bit segmented as well. The antenna I'm talking about. This is grass. Maybe I'll put a little squirrel in. Oh! He's got these kind of cool things around his... What'd you call them? Cheeks, I guess. I guess you're going to call these his cheeks. I am just copying the original illustration. Don't do that, Torin. Looks like a mushroom. Make him look like he has a big schnoz. That's what I don't want to do. Eraser there. Yeah. I guess we've decided the light source is coming from there. And, yeah, legs. So, whoosh. He's got segments. He's kind of like a centipede. Am I, like, making these segments too short and making more work for myself? Could be. There's a center line. So we can get those deer things going on if we want to. I don't know. let's get some legs. Let's get some legs going on here. Erase some of this mess. How we doing for time? 10:17. Oh shit. Insects. They're complicated. The earth, the very earth itself. He's wearing one of those hats you always see on British shows. I'm a British man with a mustache, and I have one of these hats. You know, what are those hats called? Anyway, I'm wasting valuable time. But that's why you came here, to watch me waste valuable time. Okay, let's get this guy going here. Dun, 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 dun. Don't eat me! He's got a bit of a mullet. He should have big boots, right? Because if he's a farmer. Am I wrong? I don't think I'm wrong. I'm a boot man. And he's got no face. Help me! The Ankheg is eating all my sheep. What I remember, I played Baldur's Gate a couple times, the original one. And there were Ankhegs in it at some point. And yeah, let's do the shading this way. I feel like that'll be much better. And they would do that thing where they would, you could tell where they were because they, you could spot their antenna sticking out of the ground and kind of, yeah, poking up and giving their position away. I don't know if that really works, but whatever. They do kind of have, like, you can't really see his spine here, so that's fine. Okay, that's not doing too bad. Not doing too bad. A Tam O'Shanter hat. Okay, if you say so. I've never heard that before, but I trust you. Tam O'Shanter. Is that... was that a person's name? Anyway, that's fine. Why not? Why not give him a Tam O'Shanter hat? Yeah. Sure how the scales on his back work, but I just feel like I'm not gonna worry about it that much. Photoshop likes to turn my eraser into a pen sometimes, and I tell you, I don't like it. Some shade in this part. Oh, that does make him look like he's got a schnoz. Maybe I need to. Oh, see, that's interesting what he did there. I'm just looking at the other. I feel like I want to rework his mouth part a bit, but oh yeah, he's got like Tony gave him a couple little things here. On his mouth. I don't know. Yeah. Let's fuck around a bit. I'm gonna save my work. Because that's what you do. And, zoom in a little bit. I still have, like, 7 minutes. So let's just erase all this. And, fuck around a bit. Isn't he cute? Maybe if I... Yeah, let's do this. I feel like this eye is a bit wonky. But not in a good way. So... I'm totally improvising right now. No idea how this is going to turn out. This is looking a little better, a little more insectile. First I made him look like he has a schnoz, now I'm making him look like he has a mustache. These are what I call Duncan Fregredo lines. Just like little random lines here and there. If you don't know who Duncan Fregredo is, he's an artist, and he worked on a lot of Hellboy books. Sure, I don't know. I don't know if that's better or worse than it was before. I guess it'll do. How we doing? We got 5 more minutes, basically. What am I missing here? Maybe just some... shadow from his hat. Trying to get the energy here. Let me zoom way out and see how this composition is working. I feel like I need more darkness down in the bottom. Let's save my work again. Save it. Is he missing a leg? Oh, I kind of made it weird somehow. I don't know what's happening here. His other leg is going to start here. Go down there. And yeah, okay, that looks a little better. Dun, 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 dun. Running out of time, running out of time. Dun 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 dun. Dun 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 dun. No, it's not really consistent, but... oh well, that's life. Let's get some... How does that look? Is that done? I mean, I can always... There's always room to fuck it up. There's always time to ruin a drawing by overworking it. I can see that he's wearing a jacket. I'm just a farmer. Give him toe a spike there. And, yeah, I feel like I am overdoing it now. Let's just strengthen the silhouette outlines here a bit. And I feel like Oops. Oops. Make it look a little bit less like a hat. It's 10:29. I feel like I did it. I feel like I did it. Eye plate? Oh, sure, yeah. This little thing around here. Let's tighten that up just a bit. And let's give him a little more dominant specs in his eyes. Sure. Sure. Why not? Congratulations, me, and to everyone who's watching. There is, I guess I'll sign my name. Why not? Torin 2022. 20 minute monster. Ankheg. Bum, 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 bum. Awesome. Great. I'm here now. Should we do another one? Should we move to B? I say why not? Why not? Let me go to my Streamlabs here. How do I get out of my settings now? I'm in my settings. I don't want to be in my settings anymore. Oh, I can just exit. I can click this X button. Okay, great. I'm going to stop recording. For those who are watching on YouTube, like and subscribe. I have a Patreon. And find me on the social media, Torin Atkinson, artist. And aye aye and goodbye.